Shalom, everyone, and welcome. This is Rabbi Moshe Leder. Good Erev Shabbos to you all. This coming Shabbos is Shabbos HaGadol, the great Shabbos, which is the Shabbos before Pesach. And it was interesting that this Shabbos is the 10th of Nisan, and the Shabbos before Pesach, the original Pesach, was also the 10th of Nisan. It was on that day that the Jewish people were commanded to take a ram and to watch it, and to slaughter it on the 14th of Nisan, which was Erev Pesach. And then they left Egypt on the 15th, which is a Thursday, just as it is this year as well. So it's kind of auspicious. It's customary by many people to read a special Haftorah on Shabbos HaGadol, and after Mincha on Shabbos afternoon, to recite part of the Haggadah from Avadim Hayinu. I'd like to share with you an idea that I heard from Rabbi Jonathan Sacks, the former chief rabbi of the British Commonwealth. He asks, what is the word that we use commonly in Hebrew for freedom? Well, for most of you, it comes to mind the word chayrus, chayrut. Freedom, as we see that Pesach is called Zman Chayrusenu, the holiday of our freedom. But they're actually, the Torah never uses that word chayrus. Chayrus is actually a rabbinical word. It's never found in the Torah. The word in the Torah for freedom is actually chofesh, like vacation. And we find this by the story of the Eved Ivri, a Jewish slave, that at the beginning of the Parsha of Mishpatim, it says, if you keep a Jewish slave for 6 years, and on the seventh year, v'yetze lechafshi, then he goes free. The word chafshi from chofesh, which means free. What is the difference between Chayrus and Chofesh? Chayrut, refers to the freedom of a people, of a whole group of people. But Chofesh refers to the freedom of an individual. That's the difference. So a person can have Chofesh, meaning they have a little vacation time. But what about everybody else? They don't have that. Chayrut means everyone has it. Everyone has freedom. This is really what Pesach is all about. Freedom is not just for us as individuals, but freedom is for us as a nation, as everyone. This is a very unique time in our history where we are more alone than ever. We are all confined to our homes. Throughout the world, everybody, throughout the world, wherever you go, we're all alone, we're all in our homes. And that's a very lonely, very sad feeling to be alone like that. For some of us, we're going to be all by ourselves, completely, without anyone around. For others of us, maybe a few family members, a spouse perhaps. So it's a sad feeling. On the other hand, at no time in history have we all been together as a world. The entire world is joined together against this scourge. The entire world is confined together. You read the news or watch the TV, everything is about the coronavirus and how the world is dealing with it. So we're not alone. We're not by ourselves at all. Everyone, wherever we go, we're all together. I walk down the street taking my daily little walk, and I pass people on the street, and everyone says hello to each other. We all keep our distance from each other, our 6 feet away. And it's all, we all have that idea. We know what's going on. I see someone coming, right away we separate. And we always give a smile. And we always say hello to each other. I don't think I ever remember something like that. We're all in this together. So really, my friends, nobody at all is alone. In the Haggadah, towards the beginning of the Haggadah, we read the Halach Ma'anya, where it says, Halach Ma'anya, or Halach Ma'anya, this bread of affliction, hey, di the achlu of Asana, the Ara de Misraim, that our forefathers ate in the land of Egypt. And then it says, everyone who is hungry, come and partake in this particular bread of affliction. Let him come and conduct the Seder. This year we are here in the land of Israel, and next year we will be free men, free people, in the land of Egypt, in the land of Israel, of course. B'nei Chorin. It ends up we will be l'shana haba b'nei charin, in the year to come, we will be free. What are we asking here? What are we saying? This is the bread of affliction. We are suffering. And you know what? We're inviting everybody to come in and join in our suffering. What kind of a welcome is that to a person? Who wants to come and join if you're suffering and you're eating this poor man's bread? Why would you want to come? But rather, at the end, it says, by doing so, by feeding the hungry, by helping other people, it causes us to be free people as well. Freedom means to help other people, not just yourself. There is a very famous author, Primo Levi, who you might have heard of. He was a Holocaust survivor, and he wrote a book about the Holocaust. And he mentions that at the end of the war, when the camps were liberated, the camp he was in was liberated, everyone was in a daze. And if you've seen pictures of Holocaust survivors with their pajama uniforms at the barbed wire gates, greeting the liberators, whether they were Russians or Americans or whatever, they did not look happy. They looked very sad. They were stunned. They were not joyful at all in their liberation. It was a very sad, sad experience for them, even though they were happy, obviously. And he mentions an interesting situation where somebody gave him a piece of bread or some sort of morsel, and there was now food. So he gave it to a friend of his. And it suddenly dawned on him, you know, when he was in the camp under German occupation, when you got food, you did not share it. You kept it to yourself because it was your life. It was your survival. But now that there is food available, now we have the ability to give to others. And that is real chayrut. That is real freedom. You don't need to be happy. You don't need to be sad. But the fact is that freedom means to share with others. As in fact, that's really what it's really all about. And, you know, it's interesting that the word simcha is mentioned in the holiday of Sukkot, Zman Simchasenu, time of our rejoicing. It's mentioned several times. It's mentioned in the holiday of Shavuot in the Torah. It mentions also Simcha. But in the holiday of Pesach, Simcha is not even mentioned once. Why is that? Because in the holiday of Pesach, Simcha is really what it's all about, not what it's all about. What it's all about is to help other people, to gain freedom for another person. And how do we do that? By sharing what we have. And it's very beautiful that people all over the world are sharing, are helping, are volunteering, even in a situation where their very life could be in danger. And I speak specifically of the first responders, the doctors, the nurses, the healthcare workers, the grocery attendants, and all those people that help us. How many phone calls have I received already as a senior asking people, asking me if I need any help? It's incredible, just incredible. And people are going out and they're helping and they're volunteering. My friends, this is true chayrut. This is really freedom. So I'd like to wish you all a very kosher and freilich and Pesach, a happy Pesach for everyone, and a good Shabbos to everyone. And let us hope that this spirit of cooperation and of giving and of love spreads throughout the world as it has started already. And may this terrible plague of Dever, of plague, will cease, will finish and end it, and we'll be able to get back not to life as usual, but to life more than usual, to life better than ever, where we don't take for granted all of the simple things in life, where we don't take for granted coming to synagogue or going to school or going to work or having a vacation or whatever it may be, but we really appreciate these things. And I think that that's really going to be one of the great lessons. We pray at this time for all those who are ill and for those who have survived the death of their loved ones. We pray very much for them. I personally have known a number of people who have passed away. Thank God no one in our community, both in University City and in the general Jewish community in San Diego, with one exception that I know of in Carmel Valley. Other than that, I don't know of anyone who had this thing or who died from this thing. So let's hope and pray that it should continue this way and should finish that we should only see goodness and happiness and gladness, and Hashem should bring us out of this terrible exile, this galus, with the coming of Mashiach. Tzidkenu b'mehera b'yameinu b'karev mamish. Amen.